This is
2024
Tesla Model Y, and this is the rear-wheel drive. So it's got the LFP battery, which has a slower charging rate than the all-wheel drive or performance model. And these have a charging rate of 175 kilowatt peak. And let me just unlock it. And I've got here at 4% state of charge. So this will be a good test to see whether that 175 kilowatt peak charging rate is realistic in the real world. So let's plug it in. Right, so here we've got the charge speed, and it's ramping up 92 kilowatt, 105, and we can see here the time is 1:22, so we'll have a look at how long it's going to take to charge. So the battery had preconditioned. I've been driving for about an hour, so the battery should be warm enough, even though it's only 13 degrees outside. And as you can see, after only 20 or 30 seconds, we are now at 173 kilowatt charging speed, which equates to 740 miles of range per hour. 174 kilowatt. So yeah, considering the conditions aren't perfect, it's saying 14 degrees outside. The majority of my drive this morning, it's been 11 degrees. It's only been the last 5 minutes, really, I've seen this go above 12. So it's not perfect. There we go. 175 kilowatt. So it does do it. So that's after only 1 minute, and we're getting 739 miles of charge per hour. Not that the battery can do 739 miles, but we've only been charging for 1 minute, and it's added 4 kilowatt hours already. So as you can see up there, it's saying 40 minutes remaining, but that's to 100%, and you wouldn't charge to 100% on a rapid charger. So let's just drop that down to 80%, and it's going to charge the car in only 25 minutes. So it's only been charging 2 minutes, and the charge rate has dropped down to 162 kilowatt now. So I'm surprised, actually, that peak charging didn't last very long. That was only for 30 seconds or so. But anyway, 25 minutes charging time to go from, what was it, 3% or 4% state of charge to 80% is pretty good. So still very fast charging on these vehicles, but maybe not quite as quick as the models with the lithium ion battery. But of course, when you're looking at battery charging, it's not just this peak charging rate, it's the charging curve. So if it's going to stay up at 150 to 160 kilowatt for a long part of the charging curve, then that's fine. If the peak is just a little peak, but it still retains a relatively high charging rate, then that's going to equate to a fast charging time, and we've got that. 20 minutes is pretty good to charge this size of battery from such a low state of charge. But yeah, so these peak charging rates are a bit irrelevant, really. It's about the actual charging curve and how long it charges at a decent rate. So today I'm charging at Oxford at the Redbridge Park and Ride Superchargers here. And as you can see, it's very quiet. There's only myself and another Model Y at the end charging. But not quite the same with the Fastnet charging hub over there. That I think only had one or two spare slots. But yes, very quiet on the Tesla chargers today. So now I've been charging for 7 minutes. It's now charging at a rate of 134 kilowatt. The battery is now at 34% state of charge. It's charging at a rate of 570 miles an hour there. We've added 18 kilowatt hours in that 7 minutes or so, just knocked up to 8 minutes now actually, but it's still saying 20 minutes remaining there. So I've now been charging for 11 minutes. We're at 47% state of charge there. We're charging at 110 kilowatt. We've added 25 kilowatt hours in the battery already. And the remaining time has dropped down to 30 minutes. So it's dropped quite a bit in the last couple of minutes or so. But anyway, while we're waiting, might as well watch a bit of YouTube. And nothing like watching your own channel.
Morning.
So I've now been charging for 15 minutes. The battery's at 57% already. The charge rate has now just dropped to 90 kilowatt, or 89 actually. But that's still at 384 miles an hour. Added 32 kilowatt hours of energy in the pack. And we've got an estimated 9 minutes of remaining time there. So I'm sure, as you know, the charge rate drops the fuller the battery gets because it can't absorb the energy. So if you want to charge an EV quickly, you charge it when it's flat. And it can absorb the energy quicker the flatter the battery. So like now we're at 61%, the charge rate's dropped to 82 kilowatt. And as it fills up, the charge rate slows down. And that's why you generally charge an EV to 80%. When you're rapid charging, because it's a complete waste of time charging any quicker, because generally to get that last 20% in the battery will take about the same amount of time as it took to get that first 80% in. So it's more efficient and more better use of your time to disconnect at 80% and carry on driving. But I can show you that on here. So at the moment we're at 80%. If I move that to 90%, we've now got 14 minutes remaining. And if I move that to 100%, we've now got 25 minutes remaining. So 80%, let's just get it on 80% there. Yeah, it's gone from 25 minutes to 7 minutes. So you're going to save at least 20 minutes there. This isn't 100% accurate, but if I drop that down to 70%, yeah, it's going to do that in the next 2 minutes. But anyway, I'm sure all of you guys watching this video know that already. So let's get that. Just trying to get that dead on 80% there. There we go. So some people might want to know the cost when you're charging at superchargers. There's a few more Teslas turned up here since I've been here. I don't know, to be honest, because I've never paid for supercharging. I had free supercharging in my Model S, and that's now transferred to the Model Y. So it doesn't actually put the fees up here. All it puts is the idle fees, £1 a minute. The other fees it doesn't put up here. It does actually say that you've got to obtain a parking ticket prior to your charging session, which in this place, because it's the park and ride car park, you do have to do that, but you get an hour free, so it doesn't cost you anything. You've just got to go and put your number plate into the machine. But yeah, I don't get the charging times up there, charging costs should I say. And if I go to charging, as you can see there, it says £0. But the Tesla Supercharger network is the cheapest of all the UK public charging networks. This particular location is only open to Teslas. They haven't unlocked it to allow non-Teslas to charge here. But I think the price generally is sort of 41p, something like that. And to non-Teslas, it's usually sort of 50p. Or as a non-Tesla driver, you can pay a monthly subscription of about £10 a month, and then you get your electricity at the same price as Tesla drivers do. But with Tesla network, the price does vary depending on the time of day. So during the night when the electricity is cheaper, the price you pay is cheaper as well. And I think it goes down to sort of 12 to 16p, something like that, at certain ones. But it does vary. I guess they sort of track the energy cost, so it varies with the weather. But anyway, it's now 1:44, the battery's at 72% state of charge, and it's now charging at 62 kilowatt. and we put 40 kilowatt hours of energy in the pack, and it says we're going to be finished in only 4 minutes there. So this is nearly done now, so we're at 76% state of charge, and it's still charging at 55 kilowatt. We've added 42 kilowatt into the battery, and it's going to be finished in 2 minutes. So I'll wrap this video up here because we're almost done, and actually because I've got a bit of time to spare, I'm actually going to charge this a little bit higher, so I'll knock it up to 86%. But anyway, that is a charge to 80% from, what do we start with, 3 or 4%, within half an hour. So yeah, even though these have a slower charging speed than the all-wheel drive or performance models, it's still not particularly slow. So that's still a pretty impressive charge speed, and you're going to charge your vehicle to 80% in half an hour if it's incredibly flat. But if it's not quite so flat, then yeah, you're probably looking at 25 minutes. So that will do for this video. Please do click the thumbs up if you found it useful or interesting. And also, if you've got any questions, write them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see other videos that I've made on this vehicle. There aren't too many at the moment, but it depends when you're watching this video. But there's plenty filmed and they will be released over the coming weeks. So that will do. I'll see you on the next one. And just finally, at 80% state of charge, it's still charging at 49 kilowatt there.